Yeah. So it says, arrange your words inside the box belonging to the same situational environment according to degree of intensity. Degree of intensity, it means they are asking you to write in a series, in a some order where you can see the shades of meaning, right? Like sad, miserable. So here we see the here we see the difference in the meaning. The intensity of meaning is different. Sure. Now here they have given words that have to do with the size. Okay, so here we are going to go to the ascending order. Ascending it order, it means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's the ascending order, right? And
Okay.
descending order, it means 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, going down, right? So that's called the descending order. Here we have to put them in ascending order. So like sad, miserable, cool, cold, icy. Okay, that's how. Understood what do you have to do,
Yeah.
Naveen? Sure. Let's try to find the answer then.
What's that? So like from biggest to smallest.
No, from the smallest to biggest.
Or
We are
smallest.
going for the ascending order. So something which is big, huge, large, and enormous.
Shall I tell you now?
You can just put, are you able to access my screen? So you, or you can just write the number.
I can't.
You can't, just a second. I'll give you the access. Now
So
you'll need a pen. So you can just put the number next to the word. The
okay.
first one you think, so we have to go with the size, okay? So you think big should come first, huge, large, or enormous?
Bit I can. Big.
Yeah, and that's okay, that's fine. Ram. Not able to type? Okay, so then I'll help you out. Okay, the first one is big. Then what do you think the second one?
Large.
Okay. The first one is large is the second one. Then
Huge
huge.
and enormous.
Enormous. Okay. So this is called the shades of meaning. Okay. The degree of meaning. Words that have to do with the temperature.
No. So number one is cold.
Number one is cold.
Number two is chili.
Chili, that's correct.
Chili. I think number three is freezing.
Freezing is the correct. And the fourth one is frigid. Frigid means something extremely cool. Finger in a situation. Sure. The next one is words that have to do with loudness of sounds.
I think the first one is whisper. Second one, murmur.
You know the difference between whisper and murmur?
Don't think so, but I think whisper is more like less than
Yeah, that's correct. Whisper would be the first, murmur would be the second, then
normal. Howl. The third one is howl.
No, I don't think so, Naveen. That second one has to be shout.
Okay.
Howl, you mean, you know? Howling is?
The thing. Owl is what?
Yeah. Like owl, but like someone is like extremely sad, right? Then, no, the kind of cry they do, that's called a howl. Someone is like extreme, like someone has passed away, some like very dear one. No? That's where the person actually howls. No? They cry with extreme sadness. That is called howling.
Okay.
Sure. Next is words that have to do with the level of thinness.
Slim.
What do you think?
Off scan. I'm still
Level of thinness. Okay.
Scrawny. Skinny.
You think scrawny will come first?
Is.
Have you heard the word scrawny?
Never.
Never. So what do you think? Can you guess what could be the meaning? Scrawny, it means someone is extremely thin. Okay, extremely thin. And that's why it looks not terrible. That's why we use the word scrawny. So the scrawny will come first. Okay, level of thinness. Then comes.
So scrawny first. And then. Skinny?
And I think the skinny would come.
Then I think slim.
So what is the difference between slim and lean then?
I don't know. I don't know the meaning of lean.
No, lean, we use this kind of word, right? But she looks very lean, no? Generally, we use this kind of term.
So
lean is again like someone who is so thin that, you know, you must have seen someone who is like always banded from his back, his or her back, you know, always. That is called lean.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because of like extremely thin, the back actually turns and they become like they have like hump kind of thing over here on the back and they lean out. That's why we use lean. So I think from scrawny, so the second would be the lean. Then comes the skinny.
And then
comes the slip. Now comes the level of anger.
So I think first is annoyance.
Onions. Okay. Then.
Send. Resentment second. Third is. I think.
I think worry should come. You know, we use a word furious. No?
Yeah.
So I think the furious should come. Level of anger, right? The furious. Annoyance, and I think the furious should come. Then comes the resentment, and then comes the rage.
Okay.
I think that should be the order. Annoyance. Fury, resentment, and rage. Yeah, this should be the order then. So whenever you will come across this kind of activity, obviously it's not necessary that you will be knowing all the words, but somewhere you can try to understand, try to put it in the sentence, you'll understand, you know, the meaning, because it is not necessary that you know the meaning of each and every words all the time. It is not necessary, right? So whenever you come across a new words, try to put them in the sentence and then understand the meaning. Sure. I think this activity, I'll share it with you, okay? So that you can also understand, because I think grade 7, you'll have this degree. Shades of. Complete each sequence below. Consider the shades of meaning when putting the words in order. Add the correct following words in the correct word to sequence. Okay, now we have to put it them in the sequence. Bothered is given, and the extreme shade is given. Enraged. Now these three we have to put them in between.
Add the following words. Angry, annoyed, furious, bothered. Bothered, angry.
Okay, so here it would be like bothered, then I think the next should be furious, then annoyed, then angry, and then enraged. So here, this is how it is. Okay, shades of meaning when put the words into order. So we have to put them in one sequence. So bothered, then becomes furious, then getting annoyed, angry.
Also, we don't need to think of, so we don't need to think of any words.
Words meaning, words it means?
Like, we don't need to think of words. There are just three words here.
Verbs.
No. I mean like, no, nothing.
No, I'm not getting dear. What are you trying to say? Tell me.
So we don't need to think of any words, we just do the same, like.
Because the words are already given. Okay, we just need to have the meaning of them. So here it goes like, it's a sequence they are asking. Okay, so if you are bothered, then what happens? You become furious. Then you get annoyed. Then you get angry, and then you get angry, enraged. So this is how the sequence goes. Right?
Okay.
Sure. The next is, add the following words in the correct order to the sequence. Scared, terrified, worried. Concern and hysterical, both are given. When you are concerned, then what happens? What could be the next stage?
Worried,
correct. Then
scared,
and then terrified. Yeah, okay, good. Then third one, add the following words in the correct order to the sequence: joyful, pleased, thrilled. Now, here in between words are given, so here something will come here, then here, and here. Good. Upbeat, happy.
I think pleased is first. Second is joyful, and third is thrilled.
So pleased, upbeat, happy, joyful, and thrilled. That's the correct. Okay.